interpretation of Article 51 and 106 of the Constitution, the focus has been on 51 because 106 is more or less a mirror image of 51 with one modification, that the constituency or the basis for election is slightly different than it is in the case of women. 106 is the provincial assembly and 51 is the National Assembly. The provisions which have been read over and over again before your lordship is sub-article 6 of Article 51, paragraphs D and E, and the provisos with respect thereto, D dealing with women candidates and E with minority or non-Muslim candidates. The case, as I have understood, is that it is not necessary for a political party to contest the general elections or to submit a list for reserved seats before the elections, and it can claim such reserved seats if post the general elections independent members join it within the 3-day stipulated period under the Constitution. My Lord, with your Lordship's leave, may I read out Clause D first. For the purpose of election to the National Assembly, members to the seats reserved for women, which are allocated to a province under Clause 3, shall be elected in accordance with law through proportional representation system of political parties' lists of candidates on the basis of total number of general seats secured by each political party from the province concerned in the National Assembly. Thereafter, there is the proviso that for the purposes of this paragraph, the total number of general seats won by a political party shall include the independent returned candidate or candidates who may duly join such political party within 3 days of the publication in the Official Gazette of the names of the returned candidates. My Lord, first the, and your ladyship, the first, the section which I read, the first word over here, which is important to me, members to seat reserved for women, which are allocated to a province under Clause 3, shall be elected in accordance with law. So no selection is taking place. There is an election in accordance with law. That election takes place, the second part, through a proportional representation system. But the proportional representation system is not a stand-alone requirement. It is through a proportional representation system of political parties' lists of candidates. So that's how this proportional system, representation system will operate. And the basis is on the basis of total number of general seats secured by each political party from the province concerned in the National Assembly. So three requirements are there. Election in accordance with law. This takes place through a proportional representation system of political parties' lists of candidates, and the basis will be the number of general seats secured by each political party from the province concerned in the National Assembly. So these three are the requirements under the main provision. Then there's the proviso. Provided that for the purposes of this paragraph, the total number of general seats won by a political party shall include the independent returned candidate or candidates who may duly join such political party within 3 days of the publication in the Official Gazette of the names of the returned candidates. So the proviso is making an exception to the general provision, and the exception is that where independent candidates join a political party within the specified period of 3 days, they shall be included in the list for the purposes of calculating the reserved seats to which the party has been elected to. Your Lordship, there was an argument addressed yesterday. There were some observations by your Lordships as well on the different use of the words sometimes secured and sometimes won. I stand with the first counsel on the other side that these words are used interchangeably. It is not my position that some new meaning has to be assigned to it. Seats secured over here mean won, and particularly when one looks at clause E, it is apparent that the words in both the main provision as well as the proviso is won. So the use of the word secured in the main provision, paragraph D, and the word won in proviso is a difference without a distinction. That is my submission. That was the submission on the other side. I have no contest on that. One of the counsel took a different position. I disagree with that. I think the words mean over here exactly the same, as was pointed out by my Lord Mr. Justice Muni Bakhtar. If somebody is asked on the day when the election results are notified, how many seats have you secured or how many seats have you won, the answer is likely to be exactly the same. It can't be different. It is an interchangeable word, and your Lordship will find it in 106. Again, the main provision uses the word secured, the proviso uses the word won, but it makes no difference. The party has secured
those seats. Why the both the words differently used in this? Two different words are used. What is the logic behind it?
Your Lordship, usually words are to be used in a manner to convey the same meaning, but sometimes I think for drafting elegance or drafting error, depending upon how your Lordships look at it, a different word is used. Your Lordships have dealt with the issue in the Pakistan fisheries case and placed the citation that sometimes it's not an invariable rule that different words must always be given a different meaning. Different words can be given the same meaning looking at the context of the provision. Sir, the submission before your Lordships is that for us, what has happened in the facts of this case is that the party before your Lordship is the SIC. It is not disputed that, in view of the letter which I just read out to your Lordship, that SIC did not field any candidate on a party ticket for the general elections. It is also not disputed that there was no party's list for reserved.
Makhdoom sahab,
sir,
jo abhi hame informed kiya gaya hai, subject to what the election commission confirms, we have been informed that the nomination papers, the declaration given was that of SIC. So now the situation may be totally different. It is not undisputed, subject to what the election commission confirms. If that declaration was given, then the gentleman was a candidate of SIC.
My Lord,
that is what the seat was secured by SIC in the National Assembly.
There must be a certificate of affiliation.
Lord, may I, Your Lordship, this was something extraneous to the petition. It is not there in the body of the petition or the appeal. It has been said over here. But I was referring, Your Lordship, to a document which has been filed by the Election Commission. It was on that basis that I made that submission. May I respectfully draw your Lordship's attention again to CMA 5840 of 2024 in Civil Appeal 333 at page 111.
Makhdoom sahab, wo aap baad mein hum dekhenge. once the election commission confirms.
But I would,
that will be the factual position.
My lord, the factual position also is that at the moment, there is, that factual position may change, but at the moment, there is a letter on the record dated 26th February 2024, signed by Sahibzada Muhammad Hamid Raza, Chairman, Sunni Ittehad Council, which states categorically on 26th February 2024 that no candidate contested in the general elections 2024 on the symbol of Sunni Ittehad Council. Therefore, the list regarding women candidates does not exist.
Symbol jo hai, has nothing, speaking for myself, has nothing to do with the fact whether a candidate has contested the elections as an independent or as a party candidate. It is his declaration in the nomination papers which would be crucial.
My lord, that is, I am not privy to that, but that will come before.
And it's also relevant, as we've just been told, and subject to what the election